Today I'm going to show you a couple of examples on working out formulas when one variable is directly proportional to another one. So let's have a look at our first example, example 1. So y is directly proportional to x. When x is equal to 4, y is equal to 32. And we need to find a formula for y. So since y is directly proportional to x, then this means our formula will take the form y equals k multiplied by x. And this k here is called the constant of proportionality. And we need to work out what this constant is. And to get your constant, you can use the two numbers given in the question. These are called your boundary conditions, and you can use these to work out the value of k, and then you'll have your formula for y. So once we've written this down, then we just need to substitute x equals 4 and y equals 32 into this formula here. So we've got 32 is equal to k times by 4. So we just need to now solve this equation, and we can do this by dividing both sides by 4. So 32 divided by 4 is 8, and that is k on the right hand side. So our value of k is equal to 8. So once we've had k, now we just need to write down our final formula. Don't forget to do this. So it's y equals 8x. And this is our formula connecting y and x. So let's move on to example 2 then. So this time we have m is directly proportional to p, and when p equals 8, m equals 3, and we need to find a formula for p. So again, it's directly proportional to, so this means our formula will take the shape m equals k times p. So we just need to use the numbers here to work out the value of k. So if we substitute these numbers into our formula, we get 3 is equal to k times by 8. So if we solve this equation to work out k, so k is being multiplied by 8, so the opposite is to divide both sides by 8. So 3 divided by 8, well, we can't really work that out, so let's just leave it as 3/8, and this will be equal to k. So our value of k is 3/8, so we just need to now write our formula down. So if we go back to the start and just change the k to 3/8, so m is equal to 3/8 p, and this is our final answer. Now if you find these quite easy, make sure you watch my second video, which involves direct proportion, but this time when it's proportional to like an x squared or an x cubed. Thanks for watching.